Good morning, students. Now today we'll start with the next topic of the plus one bio, that is the lymph, right? And second topic which we have to discuss today, that is the salivary pathways. Clear? So first we will discuss about the lymph. Now what is lymph basically? Now these are your blood vessels. Sometimes some of the water will just get oozes out. Clear? This is some of the water plus along with some of the dissolved salts. Clear? When this some water comes out, clear, from the capillaries, along with that water some soluble substances also moves out into the spaces. These are the tissues, for example. So these things will just move in between the tissues. So ye tissues ke beech mein beta ikattha ho jata hai, right? And some proteins are also there, theek hai, having some large proteins, and most of the formed elements, clear, जो large proteins are formed elements हैं, they will remain proteins and formed elements. They will remain inside the capillaries, right? Only water and some soluble substances will come out of the capillaries and they will be collected between the tissues or the cells, you can say, and we call it tissue fluid. What do you call it? Tissue fluid. Right? It is called tissue fluid. Then it helps in the mainly exchange of material. Whatever things are exchanged, that is exchanged through this tissue fluid, whether it is a food, whether it is a waste material, whatever is there. Clear? Now, and this fluid drains back into the major blood vessels. बाद में ये फिर वापस वहीं पर जाता है बेटा. And it flows in the lymphatic system, or you can say lymph vessels. Clear? And this waste when is collected, suppose these are the vessels which collect, so it goes in that, we call it lymph, right? And it moves in the lymph vessels. Clear? Now the fluid present in the lymphatic system, clear, these vessels together form one system, we call it lymph. And this lymph is a colorless, it is not having any color, it is a colorless fluid, and it also has lymphocytes. Lymphocytes are the again WBCs, but as they are present in the lymph, so we call it lymphocytes. Now their main function is immune responses of the body. These lymphocytes will have the main immune responses. It is also important to carry the nutrients, as I already told you, hormones, etc. Clear? Now fats. If we talk about fats, fats are absorbed through the lymph in the lactate present in the intestinal villi. Clear? जो fat होता है, that is not able to go into the blood in the small intestine. That fat is carried by the lacteals or the lymph, because their pores are larger as compared to capillaries, right? So it is also responsible for carrying the fat from the small intestine. Clear? Now our next topic is circulatory pathways, right? Now next we'll discuss the circulatory pathways. Now if we talk about the circulatory pathways, means how the things are moving or circulated, so there are basically two types of circulatory patterns, right? One is open type, other is closed type. Okay? There are two type of circulatory pathways. One is open type, other is closed type. In open type, the blood is just flowing in the spaces. These are the organs, these are the empty spaces, blood is flowing and bathes the organs, clear? वो बीच में खाली body में घूमता रहता है, तो we call it open type of circulatory system. Now in case of closed type, blood is always flowing in the closed vessels, clear? Blood is flowing in the vessels, closed vessels are there in which blood is flowing, that is called closed type of circulatory system, right? Open and closed. Now after that you will need some particular organ, that is heart, clear, for pumping this blood. Now this heart, different animals are having different chambered heart. Like if you talk about fish, clear, fish only two chambered heart. This is the fish heart, two chambers are there, one is this, second is this, clear. Aapka aadha heart hota hai fish mein, fish is having only two chambered heart. And amphibians, if we talk about, amphibians are having three chambered heart, clear? And what is in that?
There are two auricles, amphibians and one ventricle. Clear? Amphibians, three chamber.
If we talk about amphibians, they are having three chamber, two atria and one ventricle. Now, crocodile, birds and mammal. Clear?
Crocodile, birds and mammals. They are having four chambered heart.
Clear? They are having four chambered heart. Clear, beta? So, this is
the different chambers in the different animals are having that. So, today I have just discussed about the lymph and circulatory path is open and closed. Next, human circulatory system, that is the heart and other complete vessels, we will discuss in the next video. Thanks and have a nice day, beta.